When trading crypto assets, there are graphs that can help you develop the right trading strategy. Graphs showing the development of a token value, total value locked in a liquidity pool, and trading volume. In this video, we'll take a look at them and their features. If you're coming across our decentralized exchange for the first time, watch our video, How to Start to Open WingRiders and Connect Your Wallet. To see the crypto assets available to exchange on WingRiders, go to Liquidity and Pools. Currently, there are over 300 token pairs. Click either on the pool name or on this icon, and you'll see this graph. It shows the daily development of the total value locked in this pool. You can switch to volume to see the volume of the tokens traded within this pool each day, shown in the same kind of graph. Lastly, you can use this graph to see the development of the token value. Now let's take a look at the graph itself. The horizontal axis displays the time period and the vertical axis displays the price. By clicking on any point on the graph, you can see more detailed information about that point. You can intuitively navigate, zoom out and in, and drag to sides. To enhance the graph size, here's a full screen button. This button allows you to change the colors and titles as you wish. You can change the time frame of the graph here. You can also change the type of chart here, let's say to a line 1. By default, it's set to candles, as it's used by many traders to conduct technical analysis. It's a graphical representation of a price movement up or down, and it's utilized to forecast future price movements based on the present trend. Here you can add indicators. They are powerful tools that can help you analyze price movements and make more informed trading decisions. There's a wide range of indicators based on price or volume. Comprehending them would need another video. A really long one. So for now, just know that this is how you add an indicator and how you remove it. You can always undo or redo any change using these arrows. Another useful feature of the graph is the drawing tools. This toolbar contains several charting and drawing tools. By right-clicking them, an expanded selection appears, enabling even more options. They allow you to mark important points on the graph and draw trend lines, channels, and other shapes to help visualize price movements. As you can easily see, the trend of the IUSD is that its value in ADA's been increasing since February 19th. If you want to take advantage of IUSD's rising value towards ADA, you may swap some IUSD for ADA. Go to Swap and select how much IUSD you want to swap, or how much ADA you want to get. By the way, apart from IUSD, you can also swap ADA for JED or IUSD with JED. For more details about swapping, fees, and settings, check out our videos How to Swap and How to Use Transaction Settings for your best convenience. By holding ADA and IUSD in your wallet, you can make them work for you by providing them into a liquidity pool. Go to Pools. As you hold ADA and IUSD, you can see the Add Liquidity button enabled. The process of providing liquidity is similar to swap, and you can watch it in detail in our separate video, How to Stake. Once you deposit the assets into the pool, you'll start getting a portion of fees and staking rewards. All the ADA that you provide into a liquidity pool is automatically staked, and you get to vote on a particular staking pool of your preference where your ADA shall be delegated. Go to Staking. You see, you can choose the pool of your preference. Casting your vote is simply doing a transaction like any other. Fees and staking rewards for providing liquidity are just the start. By providing liquidity, you receive liquidity provider tokens. Those you can deposit into a particular farm to gain further farming yields. All these gains are there to balance out your potential impermanent loss. You can find out more about the impermanent loss in our separate video. Not every liquidity pool has a designated farm to it. You can tell by this tractor icon. If you provide liquidity into a pool, which has a farm, go to Farming, All Farms, and see that you can deposit the liquidity provider tokens in it. Similarly, as if you provide liquidity into a pool. For more information about farming, check out our video, How to Maximize Your Yields. There you'll also find out how to increase your rewards with double yield farms, and also with boosting. This way, you'll be getting up to 6 tiers of gains and using WingRiders to max. Enjoy!